Hi everyone, it's Katrina. From mysterious and majestic large cats to ultra rare deer, here are 9 amazing and unique animals that are completely black. Number 9, black penguin. Melanism is essentially the opposite of albinism and causes animals to be unusually dark, sometimes even jet black. It is the increased development of the dark-colored pigment melanin, which gives animals a very unique color variation, making them stand out from the rest of their species. In 2010, Andrew Evans photographed an all-black king penguin for National Geographic. The image shocked experienced ornithologist Dr. Alan Baker, who referred to the penguin's solid black coat of feathers as a one-in-a-zillion kind of mutation. Baker explained that melanistic birds typically contain some white, where their feathers fail to darken. It's extremely rare for melanin deposits to occur all over, especially in the chest area. Usually there are at least some white feathers poking through. In 2015, research scientist Ewan Edwards photographed a similar jet-black king penguin near St. Andrews Bay in South Georgia, an island in the southern Atlantic Ocean. Earlier this year, BBC America footage revealed an all-black emperor penguin, presumably the first one ever seen, or at least caught on camera. While there are published records of all-black penguins, they are so rare that scientists don't know much about them. Researchers believe the condition is caused by a genetic mutation. Some bird experts speculate that melanistic penguins are easier to spot by predators and therefore unlikely to survive into adulthood. The penguin in the photograph captured by Edwards looked healthy and fed, however. Edwards reported that the penguin was behaving normally as well, although it seemed to be getting some extra attention from other penguins, probably because he looks sexy. Number 8. Black fox. While dark-coated varieties of silver fox are bred as exotic pets, in the wild, a black fox is technically a melanistic red fox. Fox cubs normally go through a phase where their coat is dark. Melanism becomes evident in a red fox when one remains dark after the age where their coat should have lightened into a chestnut brown. Many of the dark-colored foxes spotted in the UK, for example, were bred that way on purpose and are of the exotic silver fox variety, meaning that they are usually escaped pets, or pets that people just abandoned because they didn't realize what having a fox as a pet would entail. Genuine melanistic red foxes make up just 0.1% of the UK's wild fox population, and sightings are much rarer there than in many other parts of the world, including North America. Some wildlife experts believe there are only a handful of black foxes throughout the UK. In 2008, a black fox was captured on camera for what was believed to be the first time. Due to their scarcity in the UK, black foxes are the subject of superstition and folklore dating back to medieval times, when villagers considered them a bad omen. Black foxes are more common in North America because they were historically hunted less, and their pelts were less prized in the fur trade, enabling the genetic strain to survive better here than in the UK. Number 7. The European rabbit. The European rabbit is also known as an Old World or domestic rabbit, or by its scientific name, Oryctolagus cuniculus, in case anyone asks you. During the last ice age, this species was confined to the Iberian Peninsula and small parts of France and northwest Africa. Today, there are wild European rabbit populations on every continent except Asia and Antarctica, thanks to colonizers bringing them as food and their ability to adapt. The animal remains genetically distinct, however, and is the only species within its genus. It's also the ancestor of almost all 80 modern varieties of domestic rabbits. Members of this species typically have a grayish coat with brown, reddish, and/or black spots, with a lighter gray underbelly. Individuals with melanism are completely or mostly black or very dark. Melanism is relatively common among both wild and domestic European rabbits, although it occurs more frequently in places where ground predators are lacking, such as islands or enclosures. And now for number 6, but first, big thank you to Wither Prince. He says, "The only problem with this channel is that every video ends. I love reading comments like these. You guys make my day." If you are new here, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell to join the Origins Explained family. Number 6, the Black Panther. I'm not sure if you know this, but BigCatRescue.org reports that since the 1960s, it is politically incorrect to call a black cat a Black Panther because of the Black Panther Party, the black nationalist organization. People who know about big cats refer to big black cats as black leopards or black jaguars, But for the purpose of this video, I'll refer to them as Black Panther since most people are more familiar with this term. Just thought I'd throw that out there. Black Panther is the common name for melanistic members of any Panthera species, so several species of cats. In Central and South America, Black Panthers are usually black-coated jaguars, and in Africa and Asia, they're usually leopards. Sometimes, dark-coated members of other big cat species, such as cougars, bobcats, tigers, and lynx, are also referred to as Black Panthers. Some people have claimed to see black cougars in the US, sometimes referred to as Florida Panthers. Melanin concentrations often vary between members of a litter, but true melanism is rare. Melanism sometimes takes the form of a solid black coat, but also often appears as black spots set against very dark fur. Some melanistic big cats appear completely black until they're in the sunlight, which brings out their pattern. In leopards, melanism is caused by recessive alleles, and in jaguars, it's caused by dominant alleles. In both cases, the alleles stimulate the production of excessive pigment in the animal's fur and skin. Some black-coated big cats, such as lynx, appear darker at certain times due to seasonal changes in their fur color. Melanistic leopards are super rare in Africa, and scientific confirmation of their existence on the continent is scarce. Although 11% of today's leopard population is believed to be melanistic, most of them live in Southeast Asia, where the genetic mutation helps camouflage them in shady tropical habitats. In this case, it helps to keep them safe, whereas albinism would make them stick out like a sore thumb. In the semi-arid shrublands of Kenya, where most of the few confirmed African melanistic leopards were seen, dark coloring provides no apparent advantage. Scientists know very little about African black panthers, however, including whether the big cat's dark pigmentation is caused by the same genetic mutation that causes melanism in Southeast Asian leopards. One thing's for certain, these majestic, elusive cats are breathtaking, and catching a glimpse of one is the opportunity of a lifetime. Number 5. Zebras. Pigment disorders can alter a zebra's trademark stripes in fascinating but life-threatening ways. In recent years, at least 5 chocolate zebras were spotted in Vumbura Plains, Botswana, and in other parts of the country. They've also been observed in Kenya and other African countries. Chocolate zebras get their strange appearance from pseudomelanism, a rare genetic mutation resulting in a darkened, unusual striping pattern. Geneticist Greg Barsh explained in a National Geographic interview that he believes pseudomelanistic zebras have the same amount of melanin as other zebras, but that it manifests itself abnormally. There is only one known record of a chocolate zebra surviving into adulthood. Their bizarre markings make them a target for predators, and they're also more susceptible to insect-borne diseases since they lack the typical zebra pattern, which is thought to deter biting flies. Melanism isn't incredibly uncommon among zebras, but the unique appearance of chocolate zebras caused by pseudomelanism is. Barsh pointed out that there are numerous genetic mutations that can affect melanin synthesis in zebras, so for them, it's the luck of the draw, and nature can be pretty cruel. Number 4. Black deer. The melanistic deer comes with the rarest color variation of all whitetails. It's even less common than the ultra-rare albino deer. Their color ranges from jet black to a dark or chocolate shade of brown. Melanistic whitetails are so infrequent, they're seldom spotted even by deer biologists, who naturally spend a lot of time working around the animal. Little is known about melanistic whitetails due to their rarity. Like with many hyperpigmented animals, the condition is caused by a genetic anomaly. The first melanistic whitetail was observed in 1929. It can occur among whitetails wherever the species lives, and has been observed in 29 states, including Mississippi, Michigan, Virginia, Pennsylvania, Texas, and South Carolina. In 1999, researchers from Texas Tech University noticed that melanism among deer is unusually high throughout 8 Texas counties, making up 8.5% of the population. They suspect that in this case, the condition isn't randomly occurring, which seems to be the case elsewhere, but that it serves some sort of biological advantage for the deer. Number 3. Black squirrel. Black squirrels are melanistic eastern gray and fox squirrels. They're found throughout the Midwestern and Northeastern US, parts of Eastern Canada, and in the UK. Black squirrels are uncommon, but they're not incredibly rare. On average, there's 1 black squirrel for every 10,000 gray squirrels. 2 gray squirrels cannot produce a black squirrel because they don't possess the recessive gene that causes melanism. Black squirrels either carry 2 black pigment genes or 1 black pigment gene and 1 normal gene. Squirrels with a pair of the mutant genes are born jet black, while those who possess one of each are usually brownish-black. Centuries ago, black squirrels may have been the dominant subgroup because their dark color camouflaged them better in heavily wooded environments. Gray coloring gained biological advantages with the extensive deforestation and hunting that began when Europeans arrived in America. Black squirrels are typically more common in the northern parts of the eastern gray and fox squirrels ranges. Northern forests are denser, and black coloring offers better concealment. Black squirrels also have a higher cold tolerance than their gray counterparts because they can absorb more warmth from the sun, making them better suited for more northerly habitats. The largest black squirrel populations occur in, guess where? Ohio, where they were imported and artificially introduced into the local ecosystem, and Ontario, Canada. Number 2. Black wolf. Gray wolves come in several shades, including melanistic or black, which is caused by the genetic mutation. Melanistic wolves are far more common throughout North America than Europe, and until recently, scientists weren't sure why. Recently, a team of researchers led by Dr. Gregory Barsh of Stanford University analyzed the DNA of 150 wolves from Yellowstone National Park, half of which were black. They determined that the frequency of black wolves among Yellowstone's population traces back to when early humans bred domestic canines in favor of melanistic traits. As a result, melanism spiked among domestic dog populations, and when domestic dogs interbred with wolves, the condition also increased in the wild. Melanism first arose within canines sometime between 13,000 and 120,000 years ago, most likely around 47,000 years ago, to be more precise. Because black wolves are more common in North America than in Europe, researchers believe that the crossover of melanism from domestic to wild canines occurred there. Number 1. Black chickens. There are 4 chicken breeds on Earth that are literally black inside and out. The Ayam Samani of Indonesia, the Silky, the Black Hmong chickens of Vietnam, and the Svartona, which are found in Sweden. The chickens are completely black on the outside and have black bones, tongues, and even darkened meat. The jet black Ayam Samani chicken is so unique that they can sell for thousands of dollars. A breeder in Florida called them the Lamborghini of poultry, with a pair selling for $5,000. All 4 breeds are affected by a genetic condition called fibromelanosis, which involves a complex rearrangement in the genome, according to geneticist Leif Andersson of Uppsala University in Sweden. The condition started in a single common ancestor that lived hundreds or thousands of years ago. Fibromelanosis is caused by a very peculiar mutation, which is why Andersson and others believe it originally only occurred once. Health-wise, the birds seem unaffected by their condition, and they're especially valuable to many breeders and fine dining enthusiasts who claim the meat has a unique flavor. Poor chicken. Thanks for watching. What did you think of these amazing animals? Which one was your favorite? Have you ever seen one? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe before you leave. See you later. Bye!